When you look at the U.S. government, for example, is there increased interest, certainly after 9/11, in reaching out to academia, saying, you know, help us understand how to communicate?
Yes, I mean, I think there is an effort to reach out to academia, I mean, especially in terms of public diplomacy, and try to, you know, get ideas and insights. But we have to remember that that government agencies work within rigid structures, and there is only so much they can really do. I mean, you can meet with State Department official, right, and you can brief them. You can tell them, well, look, I mean, this is the situation, and this is how you... But there are the structures of the government are very rigid. There are certain things they simply cannot do. And I think that remains an obstacle. Some kind of...
Like what? What do you mean?
Well, like, I mean, for example, I mean, political Islam is a major political force in the Middle East and in the Muslim world. So there was a lot of hesitation on the question of engaging, whether we should really talk to the Islamist parties or not. I mean, the idea is that, well, the Islamist parties may be connected to terrorism, and that's really a lack of understanding that political Islam comes in very diverse views, and therefore you have to do the work to say, well, look, I mean, these are political parties that we should engage in.
Your interest is primarily politics, or primarily has to do with the religion itself?
Well, it's both the connection between religion and politics. I think that Islam, like all other religions, have something meaningful and interesting to say about politics, about community, and we should listen to that message. The tendency has been to think about Islam or political Islam as a monolithic group, monolithic ideologically, politically, whereas there is a great diversity within the Islamic movement, within the Islamic political parties. So therefore, I mean, my work is to see what are the possibilities for incorporating political Islam in the political process to become part of the political system, while at the same time talking frankly about some of the issues that are really problematic within Islam. One of them is the issue of gender.
Right.
This is an important one. It has to be addressed.
Tell me what hopes you have, what you would like to see happen in the understanding of Islam. What are your deepest and most profound hopes?
I would hope that Islam could return to being just a religion.
Well said. And you?
I think I would like to see the Muslim communities flourish spiritually, individually, at the individual level, that religion becomes a private matter. But also, I think we have to be realistic that that Muslim societies are not necessarily going to evolve to become secular democracies, that religion, Islam, is going to inform public life in one way or another. The point is, how do you put restrictions on religion so it does not become oppressive?
Join us online at charlierose.com.